Good afternoon, all of our viewers. Thank you for joining us in Navbharat's e-conclave, Rebooting Industrial Sector Post-COVID. Today, we have with us Shri Subhash Desaiji, Cabinet Minister for Industry, Government of Maharashtra, Mr. Chandrakant Salunke, Founder and President, SME Chamber of India, Mr. Sagar Bhosle, MD, Simmersal India Private Limited, and Mr. Ujwal S. Kothari, Co-Founder and MD, Kothari Group. Good afternoon, sir, and a very warm welcome to all of you. Myself, Srinivas, along with Mr. Brijmohan Pandey, CTATR Navbharat, are your hosts. Shri Desaiji will enlighten us on rebooting industrial sector post-COVID. Shri Desaiji is a senior leader of Shiv Sena. He is a member of Maharashtra Legislative Council. And on December 2014, Mr. Subhash Desai took charge as the Cabinet Minister of Industry, Maharashtra. He is one of the longest serving industry minister of the state. Mr. Chandrakant Salunke is the founder president of SME Chamber of India and Maharashtra Industrial Economic Development Association, as well as he has founded the Maratha Chamber of Commerce and Industries to integrate and support the Marathi entrepreneurs to enhance business contacts and business growth. The other panelist, Mr. Sagar Bhosle, has more than 24 years of industry experience in electrical automation and safety industry. Simmersal started as a trading organization and soon established their manufacturing unit in Ranjangaon, MIDC. Subsequently, Simmersal now has an export-oriented unit and R&D set up in India. Mr. Bhosle is the managing director for the past 8 years and leading the Simmersal India team of more than 100 members. Mr. Kothari is a visionary and ambitious towards the success of Kothari Group. His aim is to improve the quality of farm and farmers by supplying effective and quality products within affordable price. The Kothari products and services now reach 25 lakh farmers of 14 states of India and brought 15 lakhs acre of land under irrigation. This group operates in 14 states, 2,000 business associates and
stocks.
All the three panelists
have forward to you.
Each participant
has to share their thoughts.
They can ask one question to the Honorable Minister and the Honorable Minister will share his vision about rebooting industrial sector post-COVID after the three panelists have spoken. And he will give his reply to the panelists' questions in his vision statement. Now, I would request Mr. Salunke to first put forward his views regarding the rebooting of industrial scenario post-COVID. Over to Mr. Salunke.
Oh, thank you very much for giving me opening batsman role at this important conclave discussion. Rather, Desai Saab is very, very cooperative, knowledgeable, supportive industry minister for last, 6 years, I found. And whenever we represent any case, any issue, or even suggestion, he immediately implement and he immediately take forward to the concerned department. So, Desai Saab, I would like to suggest, few things which is, which will be useful for our industry, particularly SME sector. As earlier, we have discussed many platforms that, now the industry started, 30% employment already we have started using. But the productivity is still not started. The productivity is not started because of the many issues like supply chain management is disturbed, raw material supply is not in proper time. Many migrant laborers are not returned to the factories, even concerned industries. Then also the export orders also canceled. Now the point is, looking at the Maharashtra state, when the Honorable Prime Minister said that Atmanirbhar Bharat, to make Atmanirbhar SME sector. So looking at that, how we have to bring the strategy to make the Atmanirbhar SME sector, 2-3 ways that is I want to suggest. Particularly now in Maharashtra, after the lockdown, many industries and SMEs have received the light bills, the electricity bills, which you are aware that you had given instructions till since that also, lot of SMEs and industry receiving the bills which are same pattern which earlier. They said pay this tariff, then we will see how to adjust that. That is one issue come up. That is the one suggestion I would like to give. Another very interesting point I would like to suggest Desai Saab. During the chief ministership of the Ashok Chauhan ji, I have requested to start the SME division. SME division under the industry development commissioner, which is not now in operation for last 1 year. So this was diverted to the secretary office, but it is not operated anywhere. I already spoken to this secretary office, the development commissioner today also, that we want to suggest you, because this platform is very useful to take up the issues, to concern authorities, to support the SMEs to resolve their problems, and most importantly, guide mentor SMEs to explore various business opportunity. So I request you to start that division again with a full-fledged system. Appoint one joint secretary level person with the IS officer level who can coordinate not only just state government, he can coordinate with the central government also. Because central government is bringing a lot of issues, a lot of resolving issues, bringing a lot of incentive schemes that we have to avail that from the central government. Second thing, we have crossed more than 18,50,000 MSMEs registered in Maharashtra. First, let me congratulate, because we have crossed largest number in India. But still now, there is a plenty of SMEs and the industries and the businesses not yet registered under the Udyog Aadhaar. So I have suggested the industry commissioner that to make a one page in Maitri as well as the development commission industry to invite these suggestions from them. So automatically Udyog Aadhaar is necessary. They will register Udyog Aadhaar. Ultimately, we will get the data of the industry. The second point, very important, is still now we have not heard from the Maharashtra government of the package. Whatever package you want to announce, we are waiting for that. And I request you to come out with a good package where we will be getting support from industry department, other departments, where we will survive in this pandemic situation. This situation is not created by us, but situation created by Corona. So government is with us. We will definitely survive in this difficult situation. So I request Desai Saab to give your inputs on this. One, SME division to be started, package to be announced. Third, migrant labor to be brought. Fourth, employment exchange, the website still not started. We have not received any information from the government. And fifth, what is the strategy to rebuild and regenerate the industry in SME in Maharashtra? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Salunke ji. Mr. Kothari is with us and he would like to put forward his views. Mr. Kothari.
Namaskar. नव भारत कंपनी मध्ये कोठारी ग्रुपला संधी मिळाल्याबद्दल प्रथम धन्यवाद. आमची ग्रामीण इंडस्ट्री आहे, ग्रामीण भागात चालवल्यामुळे ग्रामीण भागाचे प्रश्न वेगळे असतात थोडे. तर आम्हाला असं वाटतं की सध्या आपल्या कोरोनानंतर 30% कामगारांना परवानगी मिळाली आहे. तर आता कामगार बरेच येण्यास तयार आहेत, तरी त्यांना 70% वाढवून 70% झाली म्हणजे आमची फॅक्टरी व्यवस्थित सर्वांच्या चालतील. दुसरं की कारखान्यामध्ये MIDC मध्ये सर्वांना लेबर ठेवणे सांगितलेले आहे, परंतु MIDC आजूबाजूचे लेबर महाराष्ट्रातीलच ठेवल्यामुळे आजूबाजूच्या खेडेगावातून लेबर प्रवासांना त्यांना परवानगी नाही आहे अजून, आणि ते लेबर आम्हाला आणता येत नाही कारखानदाराला कुठल्याही MIDC मधल्या, तर ते आम्हाला परवानगी मिळावी. तिसरं की आपल्यातून आता बरेच कामगार स्थलांतरित झालेले आहेत बाहेर. आता महाराष्ट्रातील कामगारांना येण्यास संधी आपल्याला संधी मिळालेली आहे, पण त्या दृष्टीने लेबर स्किल डेव्हलपमेंट प्रोग्राम आणि अवेअरनेस प्रोग्राम हा खूप महत्वाचा आहे. त्याबद्दल थोडे प्रयत्न झाले तर खेडेगावातील लोकांना अवेअरनेस येऊन ते फॅक्टरीमध्ये काम करू शकतात. आणि आमची इंडस्ट्री ग्रामीण भागात असल्यामुळे आमचे औद्योगिक सहकारी औद्योगिक वसाहतीत आहेत, त्यांना MIDC सारख्या रस्ते, वीज, पाणी यांच्या सुविधा मिळाव्या. त्या मिळाल्यानंतर खेडेगावातल्या इंडस्ट्री वाढण्यास मदत होईल. आणि एक असा प्रश्न आहे की आता सर्व जे आहेत लेबर बेस इंडस्ट्रीसाठी काहीतरी गव्हर्नमेंटने इन्सेंटिव्ह मिळावे, हीच अपेक्षा आहे.
थँक्यू मिस्टर कोठारी. वी हॅव विथ अस मिस्टर सागर भोसले, MD सिमर्सल इंडिया. ही वुड लाईक टू ऑल्सो पुट फॉरवर्ड हिज व्ह्यूज. मिस्टर भोसले प्लीज.
या गुड आफ्टरनून एव्हरीवन. And thank you for this opportunity. I would like to share some points about the industry which have restarted and what is the situation and what are the key challenges, although there are a lot of challenges. I I must admit here, Mr. Desai must have the biggest challenge because Maharashtra contributes to 15% of the GDP, a state which is the most industrialized, and at the same time, it has got the maximum number of COVID cases. So what we say, it is a tarevarchi kasrat for our ministers. But even after this, they have given precedence to the industries under a mission begin again. And this is a very good, I can say, a positive step and an indication to the industries that industries are not secondary. They are also equally important as the lives what matter. Coming to the situation currently, which we could update the Honorable Minister, is that the basic issue which everyone faces now is of the cash flow. And there are many incentives which have been announced by the government, whether they are for MSME or whether they are for loans, but it still doesn't actually percolate into cash in the hands of the industries. So, for example, there are many schemes like the EPF has been reduced from 12% to 10%. But I feel these are only small incremental steps. If we really want to boost some capital with the industries, then maybe could we think of something like this, that we, instead of making it 10%, can we make it 0%, say till 31st of March? And this amount should be paid over installments in the next 12 months or 24 months by the company. This steps like this, which are concrete and substantial, would help to have the industrialists some money in hand. And as we know that this crisis is going to last for at least two or three quarters. So by the time, I feel by 31st of March, most of the industries would be back, and they would be able in a position to pay back and deposit these amounts. But to survive, a good amount of cash is necessary, and drastic measures would be necessary to ensure this flow. The other good part which was done was the enhancing of the bracket for the MSMEs. A lot of MSMEs can now qualify. And when we are interacting with the MSME sector, especially we have a lot of supply chain people, our vendors, they have one big concern that although the MSMEs have a preferential loan amount or a rate of interest or not so much details to be submitted to the bank, but they are still skeptical because they do not see a rise in the demand. Because unless the companies see a rise in demand, no industrialist, at least what I spoke to, many of them, have a fear in investing, even if the rates of interest are low or whatever it is. The other thing which came up is the Udyog Aadhar site. Mr. Saluki also mentioned about it. But even with the new enhanced brackets, you are still, the new people who have qualified for this are still not able to enter it there. The website still shows the older brackets, and many people are not able to apply and get qualified under the new scheme. The third, I think the bright spot in this 2 or 3 months was exports. So whichever industries were having exports, I can say this was a very bright spot for us because they could export. And with the current value of the rupee, the margins are also much better. So it makes sense that we give more and more incentives and push to the exports. And for this, we need two things. One is a good FDI with good technological transfer, and also a push to upgrade the technology here, because I think we have seen in the past days, there is a general feeling against the Chinese goods, both through the media, through Mr. So Wang Chuk Sonam and other thing. But even if you see this, the basic issue still remains that we need to be competitive. And even today, when companies are planning to move out of China, they are preferring countries like Vietnam or Philippines. This has to be thought of. Although we have increased in the ease of doing business, if even we are much better than these countries in terms of ranking, but still, we would like to understand what is the reason that these companies would prefer to go to other countries and not to India. Like in apparel, Bangladesh is already twice the size of India. So we have to have some thought process for this. One more statement which just came up yesterday from the Chief Minister is that if the things continue as it is, if people come out, then there could be a lockdown again. This really creates flutters and you can say uncertainty with the industries. We all know that industries cannot work like an on-off switch, especially the process industries. And while on one side we appreciate the concern of the government that we need to balance both, but then there has to be some way out. Just ensuring a lockdown and disrupting the things which are just crawling back to life will do a much more damage in terms of the spirit and getting the people together. The other opportunity which has come up due to migrant laborers moving away is the local youths. But the local youths needs to be reconditioned. They need to be trained. And unless they are upgraded to the skills, especially in companies, the multinational companies, you need to have a skill level. So maybe we could put up more courses in the institutes which we have, which could work on an express pace to churn out these youths with the additional skills so that in the next 6 to 12 months, we could have an adequate and skilled supply of the labor. So while all these points are something which we could ponder upon in the short term, but we always have to make some provisions that if something similar comes after 1 year or 2 years, are we prepared enough? And in this crisis, we saw that the good part in majority of the countries where there are also number of cases, the factories were not shut, they were working. And the government was actively able to support the industries. For example, we are a German company and in Germany, they have a program called Kurzarbeit, where the government actually pays some money for the employees who are going on a short work or are in the process of getting moved out from the company. Because of this help from government, the company is able to retain these employees because this is a phase. After 6 months or 1 year, we need these people again with the skills, with their background. And the people are also happy because even if not the 100%, the company pays around 40%, the government pays some money, and then the cycle continues. So maybe for a long term, we need to develop some program for our country or Maharashtra, where in case of such a similar crisis in future, we need to be able to address it. So I'm very sure that we have raised a lot of questions, and considering that Mr. Desai is also known as Vikas Purush, I'm sure that we will have some solutions from him, and we can ensure that the industries come to India, and moreover, in India, they come to Maharashtra, so that we are able to go along and reboot the economy in Maharashtra. Thank you.
Thank you, all of you. Before Mr. Desai speaks, one last question is from Mr. Kothari. Mr. Kothari, you can ask your last question.
Sir, at the Corona crisis, the Maharashtra government has announced that the project's incentive or anything like that, the industry has आमची हीच अपेक्षा आहे की ते आमचे जे काही क्लेम्स आहेत ती मागील 2 वर्षापासून पेंडिंग आहे ती लवकर मिळावे.
थँक्यू. मिस्टर देसाई सर, अनम्यूट अनम्यूट.
ओके. थँक्यू. थँक्यू. नो भारत टाइम्स
सर. नो भारत.
नव भारत. नव भारत मॉडर्न इंडिया. न्यू इंडिया. चला. आय एम रियली थँकफुल फॉर ऑर्गनायझिंग दिस वेबिनार, अँड दिस इज द वे वी कम टुगेदर अँड एक्सचेंज अवर व्ह्यूज, शेअर अवर व्ह्यूज, आयडियाज, अँड ट्राय टू टेक द लाईफ फॉरवर्ड. ओके. नाव ऑन द बॅकग्राऊंड ऑफ दिस कोविड पॅन्डेमिक, government and public both are facing challenges, and government of Maharashtra is really proactive, bringing back life on track and at the same time facing this big challenge, since in certain areas, in metropolitan areas, in larger cities, the number is growing, the positive cases are growing, and this is the concern of the government. That also we must understand and appreciate, and we must cope. Yesterday, Honorable Chief Minister brought this point to the attention of people. Yes, we want to bring back our economy to its original shape and glory. But at the same time, we are frightened and really concerned about the people coming in crowds, the crowding areas, people becoming so hasty and not maintaining the social distancing. All these issues, he said, perhaps, because the question was when the total lockdown would be lifted. He said, perhaps we may bring back the lockdown. That he does not want. Nobody in the government is on this side that we must continue lockdown or impose the lockdown conditions. No. We are trying to normalize the life and all the ways. But at the same time, the crowds are really, raising questions. And it is appealed to one and all that we must maintain these rules. We must obey these rules, cooperate with the system, and must not crowd anywhere. We must maintain social distancing. We must wear masks and everything. Okay. Since April, third week, fourth week, total month of May, and few days of June, we have started issuing permissions to industries, particularly non-red zones. All those districts have been allowed to function. And I can mention here, as many as 60,000 industrial units have gone into production again. More than 60,000 units in the state. And more than 14,60,000 workers have resumed their duties. 14,60,000 workers have come back to work in the factories. And this number is growing. We are addressing each and every issue. Even individual issues are being resolved. And we are attending to that. People requested us to allow transportation on motorbikes. Okay, we allowed that. And workers can now move from place to place on their own motorbikes. These kind of things, we are certainly very cooperative. And regarding these power bills, the power minister announced that fixed demand charges in electricity. It was a big burden, particularly for the small and medium industries, micro industries. So he said that we would not now impose fixed demand charges, they won't be recovered. Now the issues mentioned by Mr. Salunke, I will certainly look into those, where the bills are coming with the previous tariffs. If that is the case, we'll certainly look into that. But the government has announced its policy that fixed demand charges would not be recovered until this lockdown is totally lifted. This lockdown period, this concession has been announced. I will again check and recheck what is actually happening on the ground levels. That is one thing. The financial package announced by Union government, we are just waiting for the details to come. We are not now aware of the all details. The major chunk is also focused at MSMEs, and they have been assured a slew of supports, but the details are not known. Mainly, the financial decisions are taken at Government of India's level, since all the banks are controlled by Reserve Bank of India and, for that matter, Government of India. Okay. So the financial packages are being taken care of by central government. We are also, we have prepared our scheme of incentives for MSMEs. And now we are waiting for our cabinet nod. In our next cabinet meeting, it will be approved. That is what I am told. So we are coming out with certain initiatives to support the MSMEs to come back on the track, and they can work normally in this background. So that is the situation of our scheme for MSMEs. As far as the labor issue is concerned, of course, we saw the exodus of migrant labor. Many have left the state, and there were concerns raised by the industries that we wish face shortage of labor, of course. Okay. So we have appealed the industries to recruit locals in the place of vacancies. That is one part. And we have again appealed the local youth to capture this opportunity, to grab this opportunity and take jobs, whatever jobs are available now. That is one way. Secondly, we have already announced, and we are working on this scheme, that Industrial Employment Bureau is being set up by government. This morning, I had a review meeting, and I witnessed the complete presentation of our web portal that is being designed for this industrial employment. This exchange would provide adequate number of labor, skilled, semi-skilled or unskilled, to the industries. And they will be enrolled now at first place, and industries can access to these data and choose number of laborers, whatever they need in different categories. That is one thing. This is happening. Before this month end of June, this bureau would be functional, will be operational on this bureau. This is one thing. What we are doing to see the growth in industries. Now we are signing new agreements with the investors. There are as many as 10 agreements being signed within next 3 to 4 days. And they are they will be setting up their units in different parts of Maharashtra in various sectors. Again, we are attracting foreign investment. The negotiations are going on. We are very actively negotiating with the investors, their representatives, their consultants, and companies across many countries like United States, European countries, Japan, Korea. They are busy negotiating the finalities of these bilateral transactions. For this, we have kept ready as much as a big chunk of land, 40,000 hectares developed land is ready with MIDC to be offered for the new development projects. Ready with roads, power, water, and all infrastructure. So we are also in the process of issuing one Mahaparvana. The new investors will not have to wait for all those permissions and clearances. Just one permission would be granted. They can start their production, and during the flow of production, they can apply for different and various industrial permissions. Okay, so they don't need to wait. So this Mahaparvana is unique in its place, and it would be certainly attractive to the investors. We are also providing special relationship manager to each investor. So from day one till he goes into production, one relationship manager will be handholding, and he will be continuously during that journey to implement their project. So these are the initiatives taken up by Government of Maharashtra. I'm sure we are growing, and we would certainly, after facing the challenging conditions in this pandemic, you will see resurgent Maharashtra coming back to its glory, and Maharashtra would be certainly the topmost state, the leader in the country to see more and more industrial development. With these words, I assure all the industry players, cooperation from government side, and one thing we must bear in mind, the pandemic is not over. The hotspots are there. The growing number is causing concern. And so we don't expect any miracle to happen. It is not just open and shut policy. We must continue with all the disciplinary work that we do and cooperate with the rules. If we continue with this new way of life, the life has been changed. Corona has changed our life, but we have to live with this changed lifestyle. And we continue, we will come over. Again, we will see that the life is in full colors, vibrant, and full activities. With these words, I thank the industry players for cooperating and handling the labor issues very well. They are also supportive to the labor forces. And this is win-win situation. Labor is also very, very considerate, and they are coming back to duties as and when called. And they are also very, very cooperative and in mood of understanding to follow the rules during this pandemic. I once again thank you, all of you, and I thank Navbharat for giving opportunity to each one of us to share our views. Thank you very much. Jai Maharashtra.
Jai Maharashtra. Thank you, Desaiji. Pandeji will give the closing remarks, and he has one question for you also. Pandeji.
सर बहुत अच्छा आपने जानकारी दी, और ये कंक्लेव चूंकि इंग्लिश में चल रहा था और ये प्लेटफॉर्म हिंदी का है, तो मैं सवाल हिंदी में करूंगा ताकि हमारे रीडर हिंदी के हैं। इंडस्ट्रीज कैसे चालू हो और उसमें क्या क्या सरकार प्रयास कर रही है, आप बहुत कोशिश कर रहे हैं। एक जानना चाहता हूँ कि आपने जैसे बताया कि कोरोना ने पूरी लाइफ स्टाइल चेंज कर दी, सब लोग ठीक है, हमारे सामने परेशानी आई है, लेकिन सबको कुछ अलग करने का और कुछ कर अच्छा कर सकते हैं, इसके तरफ सब लोगों का दिमाग गया है। अभी देखिए वर्क फ्रॉम होम की एक कंसेप्ट शुरू हुआ है कि लोग घर से काम कर रहे हैं, और ऐसे में अभी जो खबर आ रही है कि 12 करोड़ लोगों की नौकरियां जा चुकी है या जाने वाली है। अभी एक तरफ वर्क फ्रॉम होम और दूसरी तरफ 12 करोड़ लोगों की नौकरियां जाने वाली है, इसको आप किस रूप में देख रहे हैं?
देखिए, ये तो बड़ा चैलेंज है, इसके पहले कभी इसका अनुभव नहीं किया था, उस तरह का चैलेंज आया है। तो इस सभी समस्याओं को लेकर के हमें आगे जाना है। जो नौकरियां गई है वो हमेशा के लिए गई है, ये नहीं मैं मानता हूँ। जो जिंदगी है वो तो चलने वाली है, तो इसके लिए चलने वाली सारी जो सर्विसेस, सारी जो गतिविधियां है, जो व्यापार है, वो तो फिर से चलने वाला ही है। हाँ, थोड़ा समय तो लगेगा, और ये दरमियान उसके ये थोड़ी सी तकलीफें भी हो रही है। नौकरियां जो गई है, मैं नहीं मानता हूं कि पूरी तरफ से वो हमेशा के लिए चली गई है, वो तो आएगी वापस। कुछ हद तक क्या होगा कि काम के स्वरूप में बदल हो जाएगा, जैसे वर्क फ्रॉम होम है, ये भी एक नया अनुभव है, इस तरह से कुछ हो जाएगा। हम अगर देखते हैं कि पहले जमाने में महाराष्ट्र मुंबई में टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्रीज थी, 2 लाख वर्कर्स थे, उनकी नौकरियां चली गई, लेकिन उसके बाद में आज तक मुंबई बढ़ गई है। मुंबई की आबादी आप देखते हैं कि जिस वक्त टेक्सटाइल मिल्स बंद हो गई थी उस वक्त 60 लाख थी, आज 1,30,00,000 है। इतने सारे लोग रह रहे हैं, जी रहे हैं, कमा रहे हैं, नौकरियां हैं। लेकिन नौकरियों का जो स्वरूप है वो बदल गया है। यही जो जहां टेक्सटाइल मिल्स थी मध्य मुंबई में, मुंबई के सेंट्रल जोन में, वहां पे अभी जो बिल्डिंग खड़ी हो गई, टावर्स स्काईस्क्रेपर्स खड़े हो गए, उसमें सारे कमर्शियल एस्टेब्लिशमेंट आ गई है, आईटी पार्क आ गए है, आईटी की कंपनियां काम कर रही है, और उसमें हमारे जो युवा है वो काम कर रहे हैं कंप्यूटर के सामने। अभी वो टेक्सटाइल की मशीन नहीं चलती लेकिन कंप्यूटर चलते हैं, वहां काफी जॉब आए। तो इसी तरह कोरोना के बाद में काम का जो एक स्वाभाविक रूप है उसमें बदलाव आ जाएगा। जैसे वर्क फ्रॉम होम ये एक कंसेप्ट है, इसी तरह से और भी बहुत सारे बदलाव आ जाएंगे, लेकिन हम लोग काम का, हमें काम करना ही होगा और काम करते रहेंगे लोग। उम्मीद है कि फिर से जीवन जो है वो ठीक ठाक हो जाएगा।
पंडित जी, मेरा एक देसाई साहब का मेरा इंटरेस्टिंग सा एक सब्जेक्ट है, उनको सुझाव देना चाहता हूँ। देसाई साहब, आपल्याला कल्पना असेल की रोजगार स्वयंरोजगार विभाग माननीय जोशी साहेबांच्या नेतृत्वाखाली सुरू केला होता महाराष्ट्रात, आणि आता ही संधी चांगली आलेली आहे आपल्या मराठी तरुणांसाठी, भूमिपुत्रांसाठी, मग कुठल्याही समाजाचा असो। महाराष्ट्रामध्ये आता बऱ्याच प्रमाणामध्ये सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयमेंट, एक स्वयंरोजगाराच्या एक दिशा नव्या देण्याची चांगली संधी आलेली आहे। मुंबईमध्ये, पुण्यात घ्या, नाशिकमध्ये घ्या, इथे बऱ्याच प्रमाणामध्ये आपले ग्रामीण भागात एक स्टार्टअप्स आहेत, पण ते स्टार्टअप्स काही मोठे 4-5 हजार करोडचं कर्ज उपलब्ध करू शकतात, पण ते किती करू शकतात, 50 लाख 1 करोड पर्यंत। यासाठी एक माझी अशी विनंती आहे की रोजगार स्वयंरोजगार एक उद्योजकता इंटरेस्ट वाढवण्या दृष्टीने जर आपण काही आपल्या विभागाच्या वतीने, कारण MIDC मध्ये बऱ्याच प्रमाणामध्ये छोटे छोटे कारखाने आहेत, मोठे कारखाने, त्यांना ज्या सर्व्हिसेस प्रोव्हाइड करण्याच्या दृष्टीने तर आपण या विभागाच्या वतीने जर काही प्लान करत असाल तर आमच्या SME सेक्टरने आपण एकत्र करू शकतो।
साळुंके साहेब, या दिशेने प्रयत्न चालू आहेत, चला या तुम्ही आणि मी मिळून करूया, तुम्ही या तुमच्या काही योजना घेऊन। मी यहां आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूँ की जो स्वयंरोजगार के जो प्रयास हो रहे है इसके लिए गवर्नमेंट बिल्कुल तैयार है, लेकिन ये सिर्फ गवर्नमेंट नहीं कर सकती, इसके लिए जो उद्यमी है जो काम करना चाहते है उन्होंने भी सामने आना चाहिए। उन्होंने उनकी जो स्कीम है उसके लिए किस तरह का सपोर्ट चाहिए वो हम बैठ के इसको तय करेंगे। हमारी एक मुख्यमंत्री रोजगार स्कीम है CMEGP, उसके द्वारा स्वयं रोजगार के लिए 10 लाख की एक योजना और 50 लाख तक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स के लिए फाइनेंस देने की व्यवस्था है, और उसके लिए कोई कोलैटरल की जरूरत नहीं, कोई भी गारंटी की जरूरत नहीं, इस तरह की बैंकिंग व्यवस्था भी उसमें तैयार की गई है। तो इस तरह से हम मिल के काम कर सकते हैं। ये जो स्वयं रोजगार का काम है वो तो उस व्यक्ति को करना होता है, उन्होंने आगे आकर के इस तरह का सपोर्ट चाहिए गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से, अगर वो बोले हम इसके लिए एक सुंदर सी स्कीम बना सकते हैं।
ठीक, धन्यवाद।
देसाई साहब
जी,
नव भारत भी नए भारत के निर्माण के दिशा के लिए काम कर रहा है और आपकी सरकार भी नए भारत के लिए काम कर रही है। हम सारे लोगों का प्रयास हो कि महाराष्ट्र इंडस्ट्रीज में और महाराष्ट्र नंबर वन रहे। अभी एक इसको हम कोविड को एक अवसर के रूप में देखें तो बहुत सारी कंपनियां, मल्टीनेशनल कंपनियां चीन से बाहर निकल रही हैं और बहुत सारी स्टेट लगे हुए हैं कि वो कंपनी हमारे स्टेट में आए। निश्चित तौर से हमारा सबका प्रयास होगा कि वो कंपनी जो चीन से आ रही वो महाराष्ट्र में आए। इस दिशा में आपका कुछ प्रयास चल रहा है और बात चल रही है तो कहां तक गई है बात?
बिल्कुल, हम लोगों की इसके लिए जो काम करना है वो शुरू किया है और बहुत सारे देशों की कंपनियों के साथ हमारी बातचीत आगे बढ़ रही है, और वो महाराष्ट्र में किस तरह से आए ये प्रयास हमारे पूरी तरह से बहुत अच्छे ढंग से चल रहे हैं। और इसके लिए हमने जो उनको सपोर्ट देना है, उनके लिए एक जो नए अट्रैक्शन तैयार करना, इसके लिए भी हम लोग नए निर्णय ले चुके हैं, और मैं मानता हूँ कि बहुत सारा निवेश जो है वो महाराष्ट्र में आएगा और महाराष्ट्र में जो रोजगार के मौके हैं वो भी बढ़ेंगे।
साहब, मेरा अंतिम सवाल है, अभी आपने बताया कि लेबर जो है, लेबर का जो माइग्रेशन हुआ, अब जो नए इंडस्ट्री शुरू होगी वो एक उसका रजिस्ट्रेशन की व्यवस्था कर रहे हैं। निश्चित तौर से स्थानीय भूमिपुत्रों को अवसर मिलना चाहिए, हम भी इसके सपोर्ट करते हैं, लेकिन जो स्किल्ड लेबर बाहर चले गए और वापस आना चाहते हैं, यदि वो आना चाहें तो उनके लिए सरकार क्या कर सकती है, या आएंगे तो उनको भी रजिस्ट्रेशन करवाना होगा?
हमारा ये कहना है कि वो जल्द से जल्द आए, अगर उनको आना है तो जल्द से जल्द आए। अभी हमारे कुछ सेक्टर ऐसे है कि वहां पे वो लोग राह देख रहे हैं कि हमारे लेबर की वजह से काम नहीं हो शुरू हो रहा है, तो आए और उनको हर तरीका सपोर्ट भी दिया जाएगा। हाँ, रजिस्ट्रेशन की अभी आवश्यकता है। जब भी कभी ये हम मानते हैं कि ऐसी नौबत नहीं आए, लेकिन ये कोरोना जैसी बीमारियां या ऐसे कोई संकट आता है तो अपने यहाँ डेटा ठीक से होना बहुत जरूरी है। कौन से राज्य से, कौन से जिले से कितने लोग आए हैं और कौन से जिले में, कौन से स्टेट में रहते हैं, ये अगर डेटा हो जाएगा तो इसके लिए निर्णय लेना बहुत ही आसान हो जाएगा। डेटा नहीं होने से ही हमारे यहाँ कुछ परेशानियां होगी, तो इसलिए रजिस्ट्रेशन होना यानी पाबंदी नहीं है, लेकिन रजिस्ट्रेशन होना ये एक अच्छी बात है, ये रिफॉर्म है, ये मैं मानता हूँ और उनके भी हित में होगा। और जो मजदूर जो अन्य राज्यों में चले गए हैं उसमें से कुछ तो जरूर आ जाएंगे, जो आना चाहते हैं वो आएंगे, बाकी जो यहाँ के जो स्थानिक लोग हैं वो भी काम करेंगे। तो इसी तरह से आगे काम चलते रहा है और आगे चलते रहेगा।
साहिब साहब बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, आपने बहुत एक सुखद समाचार दिया कि जो माइग्रेट लेबर गांव चले गए वो जल्दी से जल्दी आए और उनको यहाँ पर अवसर मिलने वाला है। देसाई साहब के साथ कोठारी साहब, सालुंके साहब और भोसले साहब, आप लोगों ने कल्क्लेव में हिस्सा लिया, इसके लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। और मैं चर्चा सत्र का समापन करूं, इसके पहले मैं थोड़ा अखबार के बारे में जानकारी देना चाहता हूं, नवभारत के बारे में। देसाई साहब आप भी एक प्रकाशक हैं, अखबारों के बारे में पता ही है सब कुछ। नवभारत लंबे समय से महाराष्ट्र में हिंदी का नंबर वन अखबार है और अभी जो नई रिपोर्ट आई है उसमें भी नवभारत जो हमारे 6 एडिशन है, मुंबई, पुणे, नासिक, नागपुर, चंद्रपुर, अमरावती, ये 6 एडिशन मिलकर के 33 से 34 लाख लोग रोज नवभारत पढ़ते हैं। और आप भी मुंबई प्रकाशन के दिन से आप भी नवभारत के पाठक हैं। मैं चाहूंगा कि आप नवभारत के बारे में 2 शब्द कहें।
बिल्कुल, मैं देख रहा हूँ कि नवभारत जब से महाराष्ट्र में आया है और दिन दुगना बढ़ रहा है, हमारी आपको इस साथ शुभकामना है, वो पढ़ने में मजा आ रहा है और ये ऐसे उसका आनंद जनता के लिए हमेशा रहेगा, ये मेरी आपको शुभकामना।
धन्यवाद देसाई साहब, आप आए, धन्यवाद भोसले साहब, सनुके साहब और भोसले साहब, धन्यवाद।